More on this hour's breaking news, the death of al-Qaeda leader Anwar al-Awlaki, killed in a U.S. drone strike in Yemen. It's raising lots of questions, including how the United States can be sure it got its target. Joining me now is Congressman Mike Rogers of Michigan, the chairman of the House Intelligence Committee. And Congressman, first question is, how'd you get the news on this, and how do we know this man is dead?
Well, there are lots of ways to do it, and I got it in the early morning hour this morning. But there are, the intelligence on the fact that it was him in this particular convoy was exceptionally good, with a very high degree of confidence. And then there is intelligence, ways to collect different streams of intelligence following the attack that also confirms the fact that it was Anwar al-Awlaki.
So what are we talking about here? Pictures? Does someone have possession of the body? Is there DNA evidence? How do we know for sure?
Well, we can't talk about all the ways that we know, but it is a high degree of confidence. So clearly we've been tracking this individual and trying to find him. There was a shot against Anwar al-Awlaki earlier this year that didn't go well. They were fast on this guy, and so all of the streams of intelligence that you might imagine that would be collected, source information, technology, other ways to try to pinpoint where he is and who he is, and all of those things were culminated into the decision to actually go ahead and make sure that an airstrike was committed on this particular event. And so with all of those factors, and then what happens afterward is, again, sources are talked to, other things to confirm the fact that it was him. So I have a very high degree of confidence that it was him. Which was a great get today, was his partner in crime, if you will, Samir Khan, who is equally as dangerous and was part of the communications network that was trying to recruit U.S. citizens to do jihad here in the United States.
We definitely want to get back to more of that in just a moment. But first, what else can you tell us about this attack? Our sources say it was a U.S. missile from a U.S. drone. What was the role, if you will, of the Yemeni government in eliminating this individual?
Well, I will say we have a good partnership with the Yemeni government. The counterterrorism forces there have been very good partners with the United States. Their capabilities have been getting better and better. We've tried to help along the way where we could possibly do that. They were really partners in this particular effort. This was considered an airstrike, so that's where we should leave that. But it was an operation that clearly was effective, and it really combined everything. It combined efforts with liaison services, the Yemenis, our sources, maybe some of their information, and all of that was put together to find him in this particular place. It sends a pretty clear signal to the rest of the bad guys out there. Listen, it's just a matter of time, and we're going to find you. You may want to change your ways now.
How was the U.S. able to figure out his location? Did, for example, the United States know that he was in a particular area for a long amount of time? And how were they able to figure out that he was in this particular car that they ended up targeting?
Well, Joe, I can't tell you everything. We still want to get more bad guys. But I can tell you this. It really is a combination of a whole host of things. It's running good human source information. That's where somebody talks to an individual who is willing to cooperate because they see the travesties of what al-Qaeda is doing in a country like Yemen, let alone to the United States and our Western allies. So those people are providing information. We have some technical means, some satellite things, and other ways that we continue to isolate an individual and try to find where that individual is, his pattern of life is. So wherever that pattern of life is, we can, with our help of our Yemenis friends and others, focus in on that person. And that noose just keeps getting tighter and tighter and tighter until it accumulates into what you saw today.
One of the controversies that always arises in a situation like this is about the nature of the United States government targeting such an individual. In this case, an American citizen. You, of course, by background, you have a criminal justice degree, and you're also a former FBI agent. Is it wrong or right to target an American citizen in this way who has not been given the due process and protections of the U.S. Constitution?
Well, I think I'm going to argue with the premise of your question. Here was an individual who renounced his citizenship, who declared war on the United States, and openly joined an organization that had declared war on the United States, has taken affirmative action to that end, meaning, you know, the Christmas Day bomber was his plot. The cartridge bombs that he was trying to get on airplanes to blow up over the United States, that was his plot. The fact that he recruited and had something to do with Major Hassan, the shooting that killed U.S. soldiers in Texas, all of those things were Anwar al-Awlaki. He was very vocal in it. He talked frequently of it. So this is not the same as saying some U.S. citizen that stumbles into the terrorist network. This was very, very, very different and very, very isolated. Once he took the case to renounce his citizenship, declare war on the United States, he became an enemy combatant, and he was treated accordingly.
The killing of Anwar al-Awlaki can't come at a better time for Yemen's president. Could the al-Qaeda cleric's assassination persuade President Obama to back off of calls for him to step down?